Isang mapagpalang umaga muli, mga kapatid sa Panginoon. Tayo muli ay magpuri at magpasalamat sa ating Diyos dahil meron tayong pagkakataon na mag-aral ng kanyang salita. At nawa kayo pong lahat na nakikinig ay nasa maayos na kalagayan ngayon. At kung meron po kayong mga iniisip, meron kayong mga hinaing, nawa idulog niyo ito sa ating Panginoon. At ngayon pong umagang ito, ang ating pag-aaralan, ay makikita sa James chapter 2, verse 14 to 24. And it says, "What does it profit, my brethren, if someone says he has faith, but does not have works, can faith save him? If a brother or sister is naked and destitute of daily food, and one of you says to them, depart in peace, be warmed and filled, but you do not give them the things which are needed for the body, what does it profit? Does also faith by itself, if it does not have works, is dead? But someone will say, you have faith and I have works. Show me your faith without your works, and I will show you my faith by my works. You believe that there is one God? You do well. Even the demons believe and tremble. But do you want to know, O foolish man, that faith without works is dead? Was not Abraham our father justified by works when he offered Isaac, his son, on the altar? Do you see that faith was working together with his works, and by works faith was made perfect? And the scripture was fulfilled which says, Abraham believed, and it was accounted to him for righteousness, and he was called the friend of God. You see then, that a man is justified by works and not by faith only." Tayo po ay manalangin. Muli, Panginoon, maraming salamat sa inyong salita na aming binasa. Maraming salamat din, Panginoon, sa pagkakataon na makapag-aral ng iyong salita. Bigyan niyo po kami ng katalinuhan at pangunawa upang ang iyong salita ay maging totoo sa buhay ng bawat isa po sa amin. Sa pangalan ni Jesus, Amen. At ang title po ng ating devotion ngayong umagang ito ay Faith Alive. At alam niyo po ba bilang mga mananampalataya, faith is certainly an essential element in our Christian life. Faith is fundamental doctrine in the Christian life. Sabi nga po ng Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6, "Without faith, it is impossible to please God." In Ephesians chapter 2 verse 8, "The sinner is saved by faith." 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 7, "The believer must walk by faith." Romans chapter 14 verse 23, "Whatever we do apart from faith is described as sin." Now, the question that we need to answer is this: what kind of faith really saves a person? What kind of faith is alive? Is it necessary to perform good works in order to be saved? How can a person tell whether or not he is exercising true faith or saving faith? In the book of James that we have read, James identifies three kinds of faith, but only of these is true saving faith. And the first kind of faith that James described in this passage is this: it is a dead faith. May kita po natin yan sa verse 14 to 17. Faith that is dead, sabi niya. And then, pag sinabi pong faith is dead, when words are used as substitute for works, people with this kind of faith, kung titignan po natin sila, they know the correct vocabulary for prayer and sound doctrine. Can even quote the right verses from the Bible. Pero ito lang po ang problema. Their walk does not measure up to their talk. Ang tanong po, can this kind of faith save that person? Definitely, no. Three times in this passage, James emphasizes that faith without works is dead. Any declaration of faith that does not result in a changed life and good works is a false declaration. a dead faith. Therefore, we could say real faith acts on the knowledge received from God. For example, Noah built an ark. When God said, Noah, build an ark, ano pong ginawa ni Noah? He acted by faith. When Abraham was called by God and he was told, commanded to go out of his place, his comfort zone, Abraham obeyed the call. So, real faith has works because it is alive. And the second kind of faith is this. It is a demonic faith. Makita po natin yan sa verse 18 and 19. Sabi po doon, you believe in God, you do well. The demons also believe and shudder or tremble. Perhaps this will be a shock to many of us. Because even demons have a kind of faith. But yung faith nila, makita natin, they believe in the existence of God. They even believe in the deity of Christ. They also believe in the existence of a place of punishment. And they must believe Jesus will, they believe Jesus will be the judge. Pero, kung titignan po natin dito, faith is demonic when emotions replaces actions. Real faith is shown in works, not in emotion. And now the question again, can this kind of faith save? Definitely, no. A person can be enlightened in his mind and even steered in his heart and still be lost forever. True saving faith involves something more, something that can be seen and recognized. Ano ulit? A changed life. And being a Christian involves trusting Christ and living for Christ. You receive the eternal life, the gift of salvation, and then you reveal that life to everybody. And the third kind of faith is this. It is a dynamic faith. What kind of faith is this? We know from the other passages that such faith is based upon the Word of God. Ano po bang sabi ng Romans chapter 10, verse 17? So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. Dynamic faith is the faith that is real, faith that has power, and faith that manifests in a changed life. Dynamic faith involves the whole man, but dead faith touches only the intellect. Demonic faith involves both mind and emotion, but dynamic faith involves the intellect, the emotions, and the will. It involves the whole man. Kaya nga po sa atin pagkatapos, sa mga nakikinig po sa atin, it is important that each professing Christian should examine his or her own heart and life and make sure that they possess true saving faith, which is a dynamic faith. Kaya mga kaibigan, mga kapatid, tignan po natin ating mga sarili. Tayo po ba ay, yung faith ba natin ay dead? Ang faith ba natin ay intellect lang, puro knowledge lang? Or yung faith natin is a dynamic faith because there is a change in life in us. And again, thank you very much and may God bless you all.